The dog park was actually one of the first projects that really catapulted recreating recreation into fruition. So we were looking for places to put a dog park, and it required us to take an inventory, and we realized that we had some needs that we had to take care of, and that's how recreating recreation came about. But our goal with recreating recreation is to provide different opportunities, different places for people to recreate. Not everybody has a dog that needs a dog park. Also, not everybody ice skates. Not everybody will use the skate park. So we wanted to provide a diverse set of offerings for our residents that would bring people new opportunities to recreate in their own way.
It's almost 4 years since Recreating Recreation passed, and we're still developing parks and amenities from that. So it's really an awesome, awesome thing to see it all come together. This dog park is something that we had been getting requests for years. And here we are, it's finally open, and it's ready for our dogs to come out. I know we have thousands and thousands of residents who own dogs. So this is an incredible amenity. You know, I encourage everybody to come out and see it. It looks absolutely beautiful.
Well, Stilling Heights, we finally have our dog park open. I'm so excited. It's just beautiful. I have so many hopes and dreams for this. Dogs love to be out in the public or out in the park and with other dogs, and so we are happy to have them here. I'm looking forward to bringing my dog Casey. He's a golden, and he just loves people and animals, and this is perfect.
It's a wonderful day. As you said, our residents have been asking for a dog park for many years that I can remember. And the setup that we have here now is for the larger dogs. And for the smaller dogs, if it's under 25 pounds, they have their own place. It's a beautiful setup. You've got a walking path all the way around the fencing there. Got water fountains for the dogs. We've got picnic tables set up, benches, so that you can watch over your dog, have a good time, let them run off leash.
I think that we've really accomplished our goal. This has been something that the residents have been asking for. We've looked for a place, we've chosen other places, and we finally settled in this area here. I see that residents are going to come out here and use it. I mean, it's a social place for our residents. It's a great place for these little dogs to, you know, to play, and big dogs to have their fun.
So this is like one of our final pieces to the pie of recreating recreation. And, you know, a lot of fun. We have a lot of dog owners in the city that were really interested in having this come to fruition. So it's an exciting day for all of them. We have, you know, big dogs, little dog areas, and plenty of drinking water and benches for folks. Just to let you know, I've got my little paw mask and socially distancing out here, but it's another exciting day in Sterling Heights.
Well, the dog park is a great resource for everybody, but we have to take some precautions for people to get a dog park pass. First and foremost, we have to make sure that dogs are licensed and vaccinations are up to date. So that is information that each dog owner will have to provide to us when they look to register for a dog park pass. And then in addition, we collect some information, make sure that everybody's read the rules and they're ready to go.